Welcome, Neslo. Like, is that your standard catchphrase now for when you drop into my stream? Thank you for coming again. This time just for Tails.
Take a look at this. Scout ship set.
Thanks again for yesterday. You and the others made my birthday a hell of a lot more fun.
Hell, even if it wasn't, I won't turn back.
Now I'm just back to the Tails again. Until I finish it.
I'll cut down anyone in my way.
Probably get a boss battle, so better save.
There it is! The Therian!
Doggo! Die, Dobby. Finishing move. Yes.
Sorry, pups. You're coming with me. Velvet! It's okay. They killed their owner. I deserve all their hate. And then some. But not now. Understand? Once I get my revenge, You can tear me apart if you like. I promise. Until then, I need your help. Guess the art finally evaporated.
The book! It disappeared!
What book?
I found a copy of the ancient book with every page still intact. It was in Velvet's house.
Artorias' book! The real one might still be there. We should go back to Velvet's house to search for it.
Well, she was saying there were Nico's dogs. So, probably was already implied that there were two. And I knew it was two because I played this game from the beginning. Yeah, it's one of the special monsters. They're very hard to kill since they do a lot of damage, but if you kill them you get a reward. Let go of me. Crap, 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 crap. No, let me use... I saw it. I don't think it works that way. Oh, damn. You use a life bottle. And that's why I have items. Otherwise I would have had to abandon this fight. Come on, kill him. Nice.
That was a considerably powerful enemy.
65 deaths in one day. Well, That's not a major oopsie. That's how bad I am at Prison Architect.
That was one hell of an illusion. I have to admire the skill that went into its construction. The caster probably has a tethered Moloch with a unique power on the same level as my Reaper's curse. I can think of one person who would lay such a wicked trap. Still, we may have a new clue to the nature of the Nomenok. You found the Nomenok's book, right, Lafayette?
Yeah, in Velvet's house.
Then let's hurry to Velvet's house.
You should become the Lord of Calamity like Velvet is. Oh, yes.
There's nobody here.
This is reality.
Spooky.
It's empty.
No surprise there. Artorias is too thorough to overlook something like that.
If only I'd showed it to you as soon as I found it.
Don't beat yourself up over it. We wouldn't have been able to read it without Grimoire anyhow. It was just a dream. All of it.
Check out all these complicated looking books.
A hand-drawn map!
Nice. It's incomplete, but seems quite detailed.
It's beautiful!
My brother drew it every day, even when his fever got too strong for him to read a book. He'd stare at that map for hours.
Lafayette said he wanted to travel the world?
Yes, it was his dream. I never understood what made him want to do something so dangerous, but I'm living his dream now. It's ironic, isn't it?
This was your room, wasn't it? You can knit.
I was trying to learn. Nico said she'd teach me how as a thank you for giving her my quiche recipe. We wanted to finish a set of scarves for the winter.
Velvet.
Forget about it. I don't need to knit anymore. Those are the graves of my sister and her son. He died before he was even born.
They're in rough shape. We should lay some flowers.
Don't bother. There's no point.
A keen insight. Eating one would be cruel enough, but plucking an innocent flower just to offer it as decoration for some memorial. That's not even a sacrifice, just a cruelty devoid of all purpose.
Melchior!
As obtuse as ever. I take it you're the one behind the dream fog?
I must say, you did well to break such resolve. If you weren't a Therian, I'd be tempted to take you under my wing.
Did you come here to flatter me?
Indeed. Although I was already in the neighborhood to retrieve this book.
I'll be taking that.
This book was compiled by my dear friend, who was also Artorias's mentor and predecessor as head of the exorcists. It contains the hopes and dreams left by a noble soul who gave his life for the world that grieved him. It is not for a tainted demon to touch.
Like, we need your permission.
Look who obeyed me for once.
Is that... you didn't?
Be patient. You'll know everything before long. What we seek is the realization of a perfect order, as tranquil and beautiful as a wildflower in bloom.
A perfect order? Let's go. There's nothing left for us here.
No. Yeah, it was.
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made.
Mafi made a copy of the book.
I know what now.
He did all by hand, and then he sold it just to buy me back home.
There was something here for us after all.
The complete manuscript. We might be able to unravel Enominat's secrets.
We'll have to show it to Grimoire.
Pulling one over on the old man, are you? Never a dull moment with Lady Calamity around.
Enominat is
time to drop off the pups and get
like a god.
We're going back to Titania.
They had like the gods of the elements, and Enominat is the evil one, and that's why they do all these bad things to people so they can revive Enominat or anything. And her brother was sacrificed for it, so now she wants revenge, so stopping Enominat is taking revenge. No, Naslo, those are rookie numbers. You need to pump those up. You need to have at least 6 corpse cars or 10. Scary.
We will need to be extremely aware.
Skeleton was harder.
Crash through!
Come on, almost dead. Nice.
I refuse to fall here.
We then didn't know that Tales of Berseria, the manga. I know that some Tales games have an anime, but I never read a manga. But I mostly just play every Tales game. The remake of Tales of Vesperia comes out next year, January. Oh, I'm going to play that one so much. That's one of my favorites. The Tales of Siri and the Final Fantasy series are definitely my favorite games ever. What's up there? Oh, I could literally just warp all the way here. Oh well.
Something different about him. He wasn't a Moloch, though, right?
Yeah. I'm pretty sure he's a demon. But why would the Abbey be working with a demon?
He could be a Therian, maybe. I mean, there was Medissa and Kamalana. No, I don't think so. The Abbey keeps their Therians behind barriers and bound to Earth pulse points. A Therian can't send malevolence to Enominat while walking freely.
That's correct. And besides, Orthrus was already here. In any case, now we know Melchior has a mean-looking bodyguard in addition to his illusions. It'll take quite a lot to stop him.
Aye. That's a fact.
Well, that depends on which anime games, because you have games like the Tales series. And those are just role-playing games, so it's or a turn-based strategy battles.
Eleanor, there's something I have to ask.
What is it?
Did you leak our plans to the Abbey?
Eleanor hasn't done anything like that.
Then how do you explain Melchior and his illusions already waiting for us when we got to a ball?
I promised you that I would work together with you until I found the truth for myself. I'm not up to any tricks. It's far too late for that now.
Exactly what a guilty party would say.
If anyone's suspicious here, I'd say it's you, Magilu.
No tricks. I don't even know what a trick is.
Enough. If Eleanor was leaking information, then Titania would surely be under attack by now.
Right. I'm sure the Abbey would love to have those Therians back.
But the enemy was in that village waiting in ambush.
The Abbey isn't foolish. They figured out by now that we're rounding up the Therians. They'll have left traps for us, with each remaining one. It's the obvious move.
All right. If that's how you see it, I'll stand down.
So you trust me then?
No. I'm saying that anything the Abbey tries, I'll be ready for it.
Oh, such a brave, determined soul.
Yeah, also the Sword Online games, but you also have games like Disgaea and another game, Xenoblade Chronicles. Those are all just a little bit different.
To somehow keep spying on us, the guild would fill her with malevolence.
I see. You're right. The fact that I haven't turned into a dragon proves that.
Thank you. Both of you. I didn't think you were giving them information intentionally.
But there are illusionists like Melchior out there. That means we can't rule out someone recording their thoughts in secret.
I don't think we need to worry about that either. Not with you and Lafayette always near.
Now that that's settled, it's time for you all to testify to my innocence. That could be difficult. What?
Well, okay. Why don't you start off by telling us all about the time you sold us out to Teresa back in Hellevies?
Oh, why bring up that old yam? You're a very vindictive man, do you know that?
You're just figuring that out? Well, there's your proof at least. You wouldn't make much of a spy.
She really wouldn't. Hey, that's not what I meant!
No, Velvet doesn't need a coat. It would ruin like almost half the game. Oh, she's a Therian. She doesn't feel cold or warmth or feelings. Well, she says she doesn't have feelings, but she does have feelings.
Just one more day, I'm sure Lord Artorias would have saved them. Artorias. Right.
I don't think I have bikini armor. I keep pressing the wrong button.
I knew this would be big. What a treasure! Scout ship set.
Don't even see that she buy a new tail or that spyglass. What the heck? Yeah, I don't have a bikini armor, but this doesn't make it that much better. So I'm just going to put that away and then pretend like it never existed in the first place.
Excuse me. My partner and I here would like to put on a comedy show, if it's possible.
Ah, not often you run into someone with the real fire in their eyes. All right, show me what you got.
With pleasure. Eleanor, I'm impressed. I didn't know you had this sort of initiative. You just have to do what you have to do, right? Besides, if we pull this off, it could be our chance to get closer to Modulu.
Did you say Modulu? I haven't seen her recently, but she seems to be making a name for herself in Logris.
Yeah, her dances are really beautiful. Do you know her?
I do. Her and her teacher, Valta. Now, I'm not saying Modulu isn't great, but Valta was utterly sublime. I worry about him pushing Modulu so much, to be honest. He's never been one to accept compromise in his art.
Huh. I didn't know that. We don't have time to stop and feel bad for our rivals. Did you memorize the script? Of course I did. And I won't tolerate any slip-ups from you either. Hearing that just makes me more motivated. Well, let's get going. We've got a show to put on.
These are great too.
Regulars here? Then why does everyone look like they've never heard of Bianfu? And what's with this Magic Azam stuff? Is that some kind of spell? Gosh, it's really been getting cold here lately. Are you just going to ignore my questions? What does it matter? Aren't you too cold to worry about things like that? Does this feel summery to you? I can be cold and ask you questions at the same time. Actually, it feels rather cold. See? I said it was cold! In fact, I've been so cold lately, I even set fire to my clothes! Isn't that going too far? Now, that's how cold I was! In fact, that wasn't enough, so I set the house on fire too! Your house? Why would you do that? Oh, don't worry. It doesn't bother me at all. And who said it was my house? The one I set on fire was yours! That's a crime, you know. Huh? What's wrong? That's not in the script. Arson is a serious crime. Well, yes, but in the script, the punchline was supposed to be, but when I saw how much it would cost to replace them, I got the chills. Yeah, but I got into the moment and thought I could ad-lib something better. You're advocating something morally abhorrent. Change it back. What's the big deal? You're getting worked up over a joke. Crime is not a joke. Even speaking as a normal citizen, I can't condone speech that promotes such a horrifically antisocial act. Oh, now you've got me all mad. I give up. For good. No, it's bad. I said I give up. For good. No, it's bad. My deepest apologies for putting on an act about something so terrible today, sir. Well, the whole thing was meant to be about morals anyway, so how did we do?
Can I just ask you one question? Are you for real?
Yes, I am. I should have known.
Oh, Majilu? She's a witch. Those are her grimoire books.
Wow, the weather's just swell. It's something I've said every day for 3 months now.
Huh? But wasn't there just a heavy fog?
Nope. Never seen a wisp of fog in this village. It's been sunny so long, I think I might dry up.
That means that fog was just another of Melchior's illusions.
Seems that way.
You happy now?
Eleanor, does the Abbey possess an art that can control demons?
Not that I've ever heard of. Besides, if they could control demons, there'd be no need to resurrect Eunomina, would there?
Okay. argue with that.
But Melchior was obviously in control of that demon. How did he manage that?
You can't tether them like a Moloch. And Melchior wasn't using oaths or mana to compel him. No. This was something more like mind control.
Mind control?
Let's say you know your target's innermost desires. You simply conjure the right illusion. Show them what would push their buttons in just the right way.
Ah. If you can create an illusion of something someone really wants, you can control them.
Exactly. You can force a powerful burden upon your target's psyche. Until their spirit breaks, that is.
What happens when they break?
Depends on the target. They might become an empty shell, they might go wild with desire. Eeny, teeny, spiny crow.
You sure know a lot about this.
Now that you put it that way, why would I know so much about it? What if someone is controlling me, making me say these very words? How horrifying! I believe I'll take your words with a grain of salt.
It doesn't take away the cutscene, so... Or just put the books back.
There's one of them off-limit class 4 islands. Place has been...
I've heard whatever...
I know, that's time...
And?
I mean,
a snake,
even worse.
You should have. I'll tell Ben.
I don't care about those class 4 sounds.
Welcome back.
Yeah.
Dogs? Look, lizards, no problem. Walking hunks of armor, I can deal with. But dogs? On my ship?
You're not a dog person.
I was, bit by one when I was a kid.
Then you've got nothing to worry about. If they're biting anyone on this ship, it'll be me.
Are you okay, Velvet?
Oh, sure. They're just dogs.
No, I mean, in general. Fine. They can come aboard. I'll take us back to Titania.
We have to take good care of Worthy and Russ.
That's on you. They won't let me near.
Yeah, well, what do you expect? You only killed their master.
Don't worry. I'll take responsibility.
You mustn't! They're quite vicious, you know! I just asked them if they wanted to be friends, and they suddenly bit me!
I'm sure you said something to irritate them, like, I'll make you my minions! You had it coming.
She knows.
But you have Therians to find, Lafayette. You won't be able to look after them all the time.
I suppose... What should I do?
You could ask Kamoana and Medissa. Kamoana said she once had a dog. Even if they get a little rowdy, Medissa will be around to keep them safe.
That's a good idea. I'll go ask them.
Thanks. We can't be killing off Therians. Besides, they remind me of Nico.
Velvet.
You want a pet dog, Lafayette? You should go to the Abbey then.
Why the Abbey?
Because the place is full of the shepherd's lapdogs. Get it? Lapdogs!
Yeah, I get it.
Devoured them again. No, don't.
So, you said your little brother made this copy. He could read the ancient tongue. That's amazing.
Lafi was different from most other kids. He read books a lot because his body was so weak. He studied all the time, so that he could be ready to travel the world one day. Which was kind of funny, considering he'd hide in my bed whenever he had a nightmare.
Really?
But I don't care that he got scared. I just wanted him to live. That's why I had to...
Velvet!
I'll devour as much as it takes. I will have vengeance.
Velvet!
And she died, end of game. And our bit is better if you can see it, then you can imagine how it looks.
Done. The art is attuned to you.
Thank you. This time I'll make sure to finish what I set out to do.
I gotta say, I didn't think you had it in you, Oscar.
I don't believe I asked for your opinion.
Lord Artorias!
Go back outside, Teresa. We'll see you when we're done.
Are the rumors true? Are you using that experimental art on Oscar?
It is true.
I was under the impression it was still incomplete, sir.
Yep. Still a potentially fatal weakness for its channeler.
We've taken the theory as far as it will go. The next step is to learn its control and actual practice.
Don't tell me you intend to test it against that Therian! Please, let me do it. I should be the one, not him.
You are not strong enough.
Then at least let me back him up.
So you can take the enemy out before Oscar uses the art? A noble plan, but I'm afraid it'd mess everything up.
How so?
It was my idea to volunteer, sister. I failed at Titania. And allow the Therian to be stolen from Palamedes. I need to atone for my mistakes.
Then let me come with you.
I have different orders for you. Teresa Linares, you are hereby relieved of your duties as an exorcist and are to return your monarch.
Relieved of duty? Why?
For our plans to be realized, we require an especially strong monarch. We've analyzed your Malak's dormant abilities, and he is of considerable power, on the same level as the young Malak who betrayed us for the enemy.
Simply put, you just don't got what it takes to handle it, sweetheart.
This is all over. I'd love to have some of your homemade cooking again, sister. I could go for that quiche you used to make.
How can you talk of that right now?
Lord Artorias.
I know what you're going to ask. Yes, Oscar, when you fulfill your mission, I will make Teresa an exorcist again.
Are you doing this for...
Don't worry about me. I'd go to the ends of the earth and back for a plate of your delicious quiche.
No! Oscar, don't go! Oscar! to that art. And to you.
Dum dum dum.
Where am I?
Take it easy, Velvet. You've been out for 3 days.
Then that's 3 days wasted. What's the situation?
Well, let's see. For one thing, Grimoire's been deciphering that ancient book. She says that this new copy is complete. All the pages we were missing are there. As for the dogs, Kamuana's taken a real shine to them.
All right then. Now we just need to find that last Therian.
Velvet, no! I said take it easy. Seriously.
Oh, hold on. Have you not had anything to eat?
Well, I just thought, since you hadn't either.
Are you serious? Why would you do a fool thing like that? You'll die if you don't eat.
Actually, he won't die if he doesn't eat. Malakim don't actually depend on food for sustenance. If they do eat, it's only as a quirky hobby.
All right, if you're sure. If you feel like going hungry, it's your life. But there's no sense in doing it on my account.
Good to see you're feeling better again. As you probably noticed, we made it back to Titania already.
Sorry to keep you all waiting on me. Get everyone together. We meet now.
Well, that could have gone better.
I just wanted to better understand the hardships Velvet's suffering through. It seems unfair for her to bear all of it alone.
Well, she's, how can I put it, a very straightforward kind of person.
But nothing gets under her skin like a clumsy display of sympathy.
What should I do about her then?
For now, just get something in your tummy. Any good warrior knows you eat when you have the chance. Even Malakim have more strength on a full stomach than an empty one, don't they?
Yeah,
it's true. Food will fill an empty stomach. But what is there to fill an empty heart, I wonder?
Magically, it was getting creepier as the game goes on. And yeah, they mostly only animate the mouth. And sometimes the eyes, which you don't really need at.
I noticed that too.
The blood wings and apparently some bad.
That's Ivor.
A cursed reason.
Ooh, Shep.
Hi.
We've got the.
Yeah.
Well,
time for some grub, Loppy said. What are you hungry for?
I'll have some stuffed giant squid. Or prison crab dumplings. Or sea snake bowl.
It's your first meal in 3 days, right? Better stick with something mild or you'll be sorry. How about a risotto or a vegetable rice soup?
That could be nice. I could go for some borscht or shark fin and egg soup. For dessert, I'll have a sweet bean and jelly fruit cup, a giant parfait, and a triple berry cake.
Zip it, Moggy Lou.
Oh well, I'm getting full just thinking about it.
I think I'd like some rice porridge with a pickled plum and baby sardines on top.
Ooh, an austere choice.
And an apple.
In that case, you should have some apple boo.
Apple boo? What on earth is that?
It's just grated apples. But when my brother wasn't feeling well, I often fed it to him.
I think I'd like to try some.
If you insist, I'll make some for you. At least it's something I can make without needing to taste it.
Okay, I insist.
Okay.
If you're already making some, I'd like...
Zip it, Moggy Lou!
Okay, Fee, I need you to find us our next Earth Pulse point.
I found one, but it's really, really far, way up in the northeast.
If it's that far out, it has to be in Engand.
Engand is a collection of small islands. There's a comparatively bigger one called Lionel Island, but that's the exception.
Yeah, I think the Earth Pulse point's probably out there.
And Gand, huh? Those waters are haunted by ghost ships, you know.
Ghost ships?
Yep. Legend has it they snatch up wrongdoers who bear lingering regrets and whisk them away to that eternal voyage.
That doesn't sound promising.
Currents from all over the world converge in Engen's waters. So a lot of shipwrecks from distant seas end up there as their final resting place.
Uh-huh. Ah. So that's where the stories of ghost ships come from.
Boo. You guys have no imagination.
I'd rather they stay imaginary myself.
We should still be careful.
We'll be fine. Ghost ship, exorcist, whatever comes along. We'll be the ones to administer their last rites.
Set Silfran again.
Just one Therian to go. When I escaped, Ceres told me that Artorias could still be killed. That means she must have known everything. That Enominat is incomplete. How Therians work. But why did she betray Artorias? Why did she give me her strength? I know that try as you might, some fires can never fully be extinguished. But what made you go so far as to feed yourself to me? Tell me. Why did you do it, sis? Ugh, what am I saying? Ceres was a Moloch. Just a Moloch. Just focus on what has to be done. Once the Therians are all together, I can end this. That's all that matters. That's all I need to think about. You have to do it right.
You're so mean, Medissa! If you keep telling me what to do, I'll hate you!
Fine. Hate me then. So long as you do what I say.
Fine! I love you, Medissa, and you don't even care!
What's going on here?
Eleanor! Medissa's being mean! She keeps telling me to dry my hair after my bath, but I don't wanna!
What? Is that all you're arguing about? This is important. Just because she's a Therian doesn't mean she can't catch a cold.
But I won't! I won't catch a cold! I swear! I don't want to take Mom's yucky, awful medicine, so I'm not gonna get sick!
If you insist on being so stubborn, we can do this the hard way.
There's no need for everyone to get so worked up. Her hair's pretty much dry already, right?
Yeah, what she said!
I'm spoiling her, aren't I?
Seriously. Look, we don't even know what would happen if a Therian catches a cold, let alone how to treat it.
That's true.
But look, I get it. I know you feel responsible for her.
You mean what happened to her mother?
Yeah. Lafisa told me about it.
My, my. Look who's a little tattletale.
I'm sorry.
But I thought Medissa should know. Just in case.
It's fine, I suppose. I should have told her myself.
Well, at least I understand everything now. It's all too tragic for words.
Yes. And the knowledge would not be something that a young child could possibly bear. I'm not planning on telling her.
That's probably your only option. But do you really think you can keep lying to her forever?
I have to. For her own sake.
For her,
all right. I'll go with you on this. You two are going through an awful lot of trouble for a selfish kid. All kids are selfish. They're selfish. But that's what their families and their mothers should be there for. Don't you have any memories like that yourself? Sorry, but I'd rather just keep them to myself.
Pish and piffle. Everybody and their issues, am I right?
Nino Island Dwarf.
We're coming up on Lionel Island.
so much for the ghost ships.
Should we expect another welcome party waiting for us again?
No. I had the Bloodwings spread a rumor that we were raiding an Abbey compound far, far from here.
As far as plans go, that's better than nothing.
All this cloak and dagger. Give me a good old frontal assault any day.
First mate, sir. There's a ship drifting ahead of us.
A ghost ship?
It's an Abbey ship. Their flag. It's a distress signal.
Understood. Commence approach.
Are you actually going to help an enemy ship?
A ship signaling distress has neither allies nor enemies. That's a code all seafarers abide by.
It's an obvious trap.
Not even pirates would use a distress signal for a surprise attack. Of course, after we rescue a ship, we still strip them of everything they've got.
Anyway, if it's a trap, we'll kill everyone on board. Simple.
A waste of time if you ask me.
Kill them all. Oh, they're already dead.
Is this... the Corsair Scourge?
Benwick, do we still have any Salatoma left?
Yes, sir. If this is their full crew, we should have enough on board to treat them.
Now that you mention it, don't Abbey ships usually have a bigger crew?
These were all who were aboard when I hijacked the ship and made them set sail.
Teresa!
I knew I was being reckless, but I never expected we'd run afoul of the Corsair's Scourge. But you know, I'm glad we did. Since it brought me to you.
You seriously plan to fight in that condition?
No, no. I know you've won this one. Use me as you will.
Use you?
Don't bother asking. It's a trap.
Lionel Island is where you'll find Dees. A fairy. My brother Oscar is guarding over it.
We can handle him just fine.
You should know that Oscar's acquired a powerful new art. Its formula developed by Lord Melchior. The art heightens a Morlock's power far beyond its normal limits. The effect is incredible. Normal arts don't even compare. Even were you to win, you wouldn't come away unscathed.
Why are you telling us this?
The art is still untested and imperfect. There's no guarantee its caster will survive the effects. I don't want anything to happen to Oscar. If I'm your hostage, Oscar won't move against you. This will afford you a window to snatch the Varian and make your escape.
You're willing to betray the Abbey?
There's nothing in this world that could ever replace Oscar. I know you can't trust me, so don't give me your medicine. I'll place my life in your hands. Just save Oscar.
Lady Teresa!
If true, this information will be of use to us. For now, let's bring her aboard and give her the medicine.
Yep. Yeah, it's a really nice boat.
So, you're going to believe her story?
An art that boosts a Moloch's power far beyond its normal limits. Sounds like we might be in for a real fight.
And she said that Melchior developed it, too.
Maybe this explains why he was so intent on acquiring that Siegfried relic.
If this is all true, a frontal assault might not be the best idea.
But why do you think Teresa is willing to go so far to protect Oscar?
Oscar is the second son of the Dragonia family.
aristocrats with ancestral ties to the Asgard royal lineage. From what I understand, he was sent to the Abbey in the hopes of strengthening his family's ties to the group.
For the good of the bloodline. Happens all the time.
Teresa followed him to the Abbey, where she's been his constant savior, even if she's kept it from him. So she's another noble too. Could have had an easy life if she'd just kept in her place. No, Teresa was conceived, outside of formal matrimony. And her mother was not of what you call high standing.
It happens more often than you might think. My mother died, and my father's wife never cared for me. So I merely served the Dragonia family as a maid. Those were dark, lonely times for me. But Oscar... Oscar was the only one who called me his sister and embraced me as family. Does a sister need any other reason to want to save her brother?
So you're back on your feet.
My sincere thanks for the medicine.
I can't use you as a hostage if you're dead. Where's the Therian?
Ahead through the Baird Marsh are the ruins of an ancient kingdom. There you'll find the Earth Pulse Point, along with Oscar.
What happened to number one?
Lord Artorias took number one away from me. As it stands, I'm without the powers of an exorcist. As such, whether I live or die is for you people to decide. Once Oscar is safe, you can do whatever you like to me.
You'll do as you wish. All of it.
Scout ship setting sail.
I know you know this, Fee, but don't let your guard down for one second.
I won't.
This is a nice place to stop. I will be continuing this again next Wednesday and every Wednesday after that until I finally finish it or there's a game release that I really have want to play. Thank you all for watching again. And I'll see you next time. Bye.